Good morning from one of my favorite places in the entire world, California, the eastern Sierra Nevada. Today, I'm heading out to Hetch Hetchy, part of Yosemite National Park, to explore something I've never seen before, and I can't wait to get there and jump in with you. Wow. This is absolutely stunning and just mind-blowing. I'm not used to seeing scales like this. These are gigantic rocks out here. It's July 4th weekend and we still see snow, something I definitely don't get to see a lot of in Phoenix. I'm currently about 68 miles from my destination, but about an hour and 45 minutes. And I think that's the normal time. I'm just guessing it's kind of slow going through these mountain passes. Not sure if I'm gonna have to wait to get permitted in or what's gonna happen. So I'm sure all of those factors will come into play somehow. Woo doggy, that was a close call. I almost got turned around. I got to the entrance gate to Yosemite, which I expected, and asked one of the, I don't know if he was an official ranger or volunteer, do I need a reservation to get over to Hetch Hetchy? And he said yes. And I said, okay. And I said, do I need to turn around? And then I thought it wise just to confirm. I said, the website says I didn't need a reservation. So then he decided to check with one of the other rangers who confirmed that, yes, I am authorized to pass through. So they gave me a pass, showed my national parks pass. So you would have to pay entry to get to where I'm going. But the section I'm going to is not as frequently visited by others, not as crowded. So I guess they don't need to require reservations for it. That would have sucked. Okay, so I finally found the people, I think. There's the, I think it's the Tuolumne is how it's pronounced, river. And there are a ton of people. And this is Tuolumne Meadows. I think I've heard of that, actually. Now it's kind of coming back to me. I think I know why I recognize the name Tuolumne Meadows. I think that may have been one of the campgrounds. I think there's a campground there, is there not? If there is, I think I had a reservation there once and I had to cancel my trip due to late season inclement weather about a year ago. Otherwise, you would have seen Yosemite episodes by now. These kind of views might be a dime a dozen in this park, I don't know, but for me, this is paradise. Water is crystal clear. Look at that. Probably some fishing in there. Giant mountains up here. Look at that. So this is a problem. How am I going to take you to our main destination if I'm going to be seeing views like this all along the way? It's just got to be disciplined, I guess. So yeah, I'm going to hit the road again, but my goodness, this is amazing. Feels like we're climbing an elevation again. And you can see all of that solid gray rock. I always hear the word granite rock when you talk about Yosemite, so I'm assuming this is granite. And if I'm wrong, please correct me. And I never take anything that you guys tell me for granite. Get it? Oh, what's this? There's another point here. It's like, I feel like I gotta stop. I mean, come on. Is that Half Dome that I spy on the horizon? I don't know. Let's go check this out. What the heck is that? Is that just a really plump squirrel? Now I'm looking at it, I'm not so sure. I'm at a loss. What are you, fella? So that little creature back there I learned is a marmot. So that there are these other folks that were kind of saw what I was doing, and I overheard him talking, and I went and talked to the guy, and yeah, he said he gets lots of those on a golf course that he played at. So, but he seemed to know a bit about them, and I guess it makes sense. I've always heard of marmots. I've probably seen them in zoos or in captivity, but I can't say that I've ever seen one in the wild. I parked here in some overflow parking that you see behind me here at Hetch Hetchy, and I'm now making my way down towards the dam. There was a sign that said there's more day use parking down this way, and I estimate I'm not far, so I didn't want a chance going down there, but I do think I saw some cars go down this way and they didn't come back, so there probably is better parking than what I did. That's all right though, I could use the exercise. There's your first really good look at the reservoir here at Hetch Hetchy. Oh wow, waterfall. You can actually hear the waterfall from here. How beautiful. Look at how magnificent that looks. This is so picturesque. And barely any people. This already has wow factor times 10. That is amazing. I'm sure you'll get more of the story as we go along, but now you can see how this whole area was dammed off. And apparently this was almost equivalent in beauty to like the main Yosemite Valley. And then they just, in the 1930s, I want to say it was, dammed this off to help quench the thirsts of those in San Francisco. They wanted to use a natural resource to supply people with energy, and here's what happened. So I believe those falls are our destination that you see off in the distance. I asked the ranger how far we're looking. About 2.5 miles in and back, so about 5 miles round trip. No problem. And this here is quite spectacular too. This is really the view you want. That is a long ways down, my friends, and very windy. You can hear the water, just look at that over there. That must be where the outlet is, I'm guessing, for this dam here in front of us. At this rate, I'm gonna get nothing done. All the people that I was talking to, some people here up on the bridge. So, hey guy, the guy that asked me if I'm a YouTuber and I told you my channel name, if you see this video, hope you guys enjoyed the falls too. I mean, this is crazy. Look at that. Okay, we're heading towards this tunnel on the other side of the dam. And I have a feeling this is gonna rock. Check this out. This is awesome. I estimate I'm about the halfway point of the tunnel. It's pretty short, but it's still impressive. They've got lights in here. You can see it's very well lit. Very big and open. It's not scary. If you're scared of the dark or tight places, I don't think this will freak you out. Okay, time to put the sunglasses on again. And we re-enter the light. And I think this whole part is probably gonna be very exposed with little to no shade, according to the ranger. I probably don't even really need to talk on this episode. I could just film this, right? And not say anything. And that would be totally acceptable. This is like something from a dream. I've heard the water is frigid over there on that waterfall, but I am hot. So I'm hoping maybe I can cool off without feeling freezing. As the day goes on, there are a few more people kind of trickling through. I get passed a lot because I stop and take pictures and stuff, but overall, yeah, you can find plenty of places to keep to yourself with no problems, which I don't think would be the case if we went into the main part of Yosemite. Starting to climb in elevation a little bit, but nothing too bad. A lot of people had to stop and take a break in the woods back there on this uphill section. Oh, look, you can actually see the dam where we started. So that should show you how far we came. Here's some signage. What do we got here? The beehive is 6.5 miles. Oh, we actually want to go this way. The falls, Wapama Falls. This is the way we want to go. Looks like we're heading back towards the shoreline now. Kind of cut in through the woods here for a little bit. All right, starting to catch my breath again. Ah, this is a really nice view here. It's hard to believe that this used to just be a valley and all this water wasn't here. And the accounts of what it looked like were spectacular. This does add its own kind of beauty to it, but I have watched a couple reports and found out that I think they did studies where they can service the water needs or the energy needs of cities like San Francisco and LA without having to do this. So maybe in my lifetime we'll see this reverted back to its previous state. Made it to the falls, and I can already see that the falls are not in their at their strongest. I've seen videos of this bridge behind me just enveloped in mist, and you can actually see if we look at the sign over here. So apparently the water can flow so hard that it could be fatal, just to give you an idea. But today I don't think we're gonna get any mist or spray, but we might be able to get better pictures. Check that out. Wapama Falls at Hetch Hetchy. I made it. It's beautiful. Those people down there have the right idea, I'd say. There aren't too many good spots left. Oh, look at this down here. It's a little oasis down there.
I'm actually not too sad that the falls aren't kind of flowing on top of the bridge. I think it would have felt really good. There are people that are swimming, so I guess the water is not too cold. Probably brisk. But as usual, I'm really running out of time and I need to hightail it back to my car because I've got other things planned for today. And of course, this is taking a lot longer than I thought. Not because it's really that long of a thing, but because I just stop and take way too many pictures. But how can you blame me? I mean, look at that. Thank you.